So the C5 Corvette has really neat headlights. The problem on these early models, 97, 98, 99, is there's a little bit of an issue with them, and I'm going to show you that here right now. Well, hey, everybody. This is JT from Rubber City Motoring. I am back here with the Corvette, and this is a, I don't want to say a cheap fix, but it's something that that my Corvette needed, and if your early C5 doesn't have this problem, it probably will eventually. Okay, so... I've done this already once. This is the driver side, this is passenger side. So the buckets there look pretty similar. They just, you know, they surround the headlights, and I put them back down. When I bought it, this was one of the few issues with it. The guy I bought it from basically said, hey, I put the plugs in the headlight here. That's like an access port. And they flew right out. They you know, he said, oh, I, you know, tried to replace them, boom, gone. So I researched this and I found that they fixed this starting in 2001, I believe, 2000, right around then. And so there's a newer style which you can very easily upgrade your C5 for. This is it right here. This is the passenger side, and if you look at the difference, it's got little notches and stuff in it like that right there, as opposed to a smooth plug there, all notched out and stuff here. And I actually bought a new plug here, GM parts, pretty simple, just there's that there, and that one there, if you can read that. So I'm going to show you how to install these here. You pop the headlights up, and it's basically three Phillips screws. So let's get this going here on the passenger side, which is all that I have left. And then I don't want to say these are junk, but these are definitely not anything that I'm going to use again. So here we go. Quick look here, what we're dealing with. Two Phillips head screws on the inside. One on the outside. And then they clip sort of up top there. And to come over here, that is the new one installed on the driver's side. Nice and secure in there, and it really does lock in there. So let me take this off, and then we'll remove it. Removal on this guy, I was slightly worried I was gonna have to take something apart, go crazy in that. Now, this car is very slippery, very waxed up. So let's see if I can pull this out of here without the camera falling. There's like a clip right here. You kind of basically kind of wiggle your way out. And if you can get your fingers in here, it helps. Let's see. Oh, this, there it goes. This has been installed in the car since 1999, I'm guessing. So, you know, it's got a little bit of, and that's it. Here's our old one out right there. Even has a cobweb in it. Look at that. So our new one, basically you can go down in. You want to get this, there's like a metal like springy clip on here. You want to make sure you don't get anything caught, but this little tab up on top goes above the metal clip. And if it doesn't fit, you just kind of wiggle it. And it really just kind of falls into place. And you can see here, you want to get the screws sort of lined up. I wouldn't tighten one over the other, but that's gonna be it. So I'm gonna put the screws in here now. As I said, you wanna start all three. You don't necessarily wanna torque one only. These don't have to be crazy torqued, and the plastic is pretty flimsy. So it doesn't necessarily like, it's not like a lock-in fit, like it kind of bends and flexes, and that's it, that part's in. Now we can move on to the plug right there, which that was the original issue to begin with. So I like to use a big flathead in there so it kind of force fit in there. And I found these only sort of fit one way. And that's pretty much it. It's in there. It's got like a little lock type thing, but I mean, it's not Let's put it this way. It fits better than the push-in plugs there. This, you can tell it kind of spins in and holds. And then that's it. It's in there. It's weird because you don't want to, like, if stripping this flathead is a thing, you can see it. It kind of goes a little too far there if you turn too hard with your screwdriver, but that's it. So I now have my holes covered here. My screws are in. They look exactly the same. This is more of a upgrade slash hack, whatever you want to call it. This isn't anything crazy. I found these on eBay. It was both sides, the plugs, and everything shipped. I think it was like $49. Little pricey for what it is, but it was weird driving home with this thing when I first got it, and I popped the headlights up, and there's just a big hole there with the light coming out, and I don't want to say like it, I would assume it's not good for it to get rain and dirt and stuff in there, but, you know, it's one of those things. It's like just kind of finishes the car. If you have one of these early C5s, 97, 98, 99, and I believe 2000, so check your car. If you are missing your plugs, or if you don't have those screw-in ones, this will definitely benefit you. So thanks for watching. We'll see you next time here on Rubber City Motoring. For more on the Corvette, subscribe. We're definitely going to have more as this car gets modified and, you know, has some stuff done to it. Not a ton, but I'll definitely keep posting on it here. So thanks for watching, and have a good one.